All right, Charles F. Lewis Natural Area, 384 acres in Glidden State Forest. I'm going to show you this map real quick. I don't know if you can see it. We're going to take like the big outer loop today. It's like a 5-mile loop. This is your parking area off of 403. It's a very hidden parking lot. You can miss it very easily. It's got some nice views. Good mix of terrain. Kind of difficult. Not really taken care of a hell of a lot. A lot of things to trip on for a while. We'll actually be coming back across that little creek. They have improved the markings over the last year on the trees. It's still not the best. I'm gonna take it a little easy today, especially in this first section. Now, this whole first, like, I don't know, we'll say over half a mile, you got some nice little water features the whole way up the trail. Watch these rocks in the winter. They're very, very slick. Again, you got a nice view coming up. Before I forget, I recommend pants or calf sleeves if you're going to come do this trail with all the overgrown things. Got a nice little waterfall there. Obviously, the water is a lot nicer after it rains. It's been a little dry. And we're going uphill basically the first mile or so. I'm not sure how much elevation is in the 5-mile loop. I know it's at least like 1500 feet of gain. A 1000 feet before the first look where you actually can see across the river, or Connemara River. This tree's all hollowed out. It does look like they did a little bit more marking this year since I've been out like 2 months ago. Could be wrong. Trust me, it's a lot better than what it used to be. It's still not perfect. Especially where they timbered at. I'll show you a nice little view of the valley real quick. Right down there, one of my favorite spots when it's really wet and flowing pretty good. It's like a natural water slide type deal. just looks cool. See, it goes the whole way. See how it's still going? The shorter loop's over on the other side, but again, we're taking the longer one. Now there's the shorter loop. Again, takes you over there. We're going up Ranger Mountain Trail. So far we're 500 feet a gain, 537 to be exact. Oh, it's really gonna be overgrown up top. Damn. Don't worry, we're not on top yet. It does flatten here though. Oh, there's some deer. You're gonna have sections like this right now, but you just have to keep your head up. Look for the markings. I just got 1 mile. I think I missed the mile marker. So 1 mile in, according to my stats, I got 692 feet of gain, 4 feet of descent, a mile in. Oh, here comes the mile marker. Whew, mile one. They're not the greatest mile markers. You gotta watch for them. I think a couple don't have that paint on top. So that on my watch is 1.1 in. Only at 900 feet of gain so far. Thank you. I'm gonna take it easy in this little section right here so I don't step on any snakes or bees' nests. Now, I want to show you something real quick. This is an awesome view. Really can't see nothing behind you, but you can see like the Sword power plant and the valleys. Straight ahead, hopefully the sun's not shining, but on the other side, that top of the hill, take a guess what that is. That's the Laurel Highlands hiking trail, about a mile and a half in, which we're probably about the same on this side, but over there, that whole ridge that you can see, that's the Laurel Highlands hiking trail. You can see the incline a little bit of the hill as you're going up. So that's your view on the hiking trail, 1.5 in, you know, after that Laurel tunnels and stuff. And then down below in the valley right now is the Connemara River, and on that side is 56 Hoss Pike, and this is 403 side of the valley, whatever you want to call it. Give it a little brief description where we're at. Yeah, see, I'm definitely not running through this shit. Step on something. All right, so there we have 959 feet of gain, 7 feet of descent. So you're basically going uphill the first mile and a half. Well, we're still going uphill, but whatever, to the view. Oh, if you see the orange or red, that used to be the old markings of the trail. DCNR sort of tried to standardize it a little bit for yellow, but now we're running on a ridge line like right now. Now Now we got some big rocks we're gonna run around and over. I like this rock for some reason, I don't know why. Just cool. I hate this. As you see, this is not really maintained. Got some ankle biters right there. Oh, got a fern on me. Sticks the wrong way. All right, I got mile two done, three to go. Let's see what I got for 1,105 feet of gain, 40 feet of descent, and those 2 miles so far. I want to say it gets a lot more runnable now, but I will throw in the asterisk of sections are runnable. We still got a big rock garden and a couple jagger sections. There's your mile two. See, that one's really dark, so you'd miss it. I would have missed it if I just didn't happen to glance at it. Now this is an access road, obviously. you could take at, I forget how many miles it is, I only did it once. I want to say at least 5 or 7. Actually take you like behind the Evansburg like mini mall way. Oh, which way am I going? Yeah, maybe this way. Spider one. Always be careful on these little bridges. Can be slick. All right, another running section, so we don't step on anything. Nice little view. You really see the power plant there, sewers, there's New Florence's. There's that access road, but I have no idea how to access that. I think it's more of a private thing. Prime example, I said at the beginning of the video, wear pants or cap sleeves. Hmm. spider web. Ah, that was a good spider web. Damn it. Alright, this is where I always get confused. I always forget which way to go. Should be this way. Now, it's hard to see some of these markings because they're sort of hidden. Plus, we're in a section that they logged. I don't know if it was 2 years ago now or last year, whatever. So you have to pay attention, because yeah, you see the marking over there. You just have to sort of get lucky and catch it and not take this stupid road down. And again, you know, you can't really see any markings. You just barely see that one up there. Thank you. Here, I'll give you a quick little view of this area. And we just hit mile three. There's no easy way. So 3 miles in, 1,213 feet of gain, 309 down. Ow. There's your mile three. See this little cool fern section where they logged it out. Again, there's really not many markings. All right, so right now, let's see here, 3.2 in, I got about 1.8 left. We're just out of the logging section, 1,213 feet, 380 feet down. And I want to switch. Porcupine's up the tree. Oh, fuck! I don't know if I just stepped on a bee's nest or spider web, but whatever. Oh, All right, so we're gonna be in this big, I guess, rock garden, whatever you wanna call it right now, for a couple of tents. So watch your ankles, watch for snakes, bees. And I did hit 4 miles. And I'm at, I'm still at 1234. Descent, 791. Descent. Alright, well there's mile marker 4. I guess if you could really see it, whatever. I'll turn around real quick, give you a little perspective. Forgot to do that a little earlier. There's another little rock facing, I guess you want to call it. But I'm not running through this shit. I don't need to twist an ankle. Still could, but whatever. Another quick view while we were just going it through. A lot of potential for critters to hide. Nice big rock outcropping. All right, we gotta go that way. But I wanna show you this view real quick. It's right out here. All right. That's your view. It's a little better in the fall. Well, I guess I go that way. I'll just go the way I came. Now these last couple tents sort of suck, but whatever. It's a lot of big rocks. I mean, you can see the road down there. We're getting there, we're circling back. We got maybe 3 tents to go. But it's a dangerous 3 tents. Let's see, we're circling around to that creek. Whew. You can walk across those, obviously. Go up here, show this real quick. This is usually pretty nice after a nice rain. Just come and sit and watch. Got a couple little waterfall features there. Obviously they're not too great right now, but whatever. There's where we actually went up that way. And we're gonna head out. So it's kind of a crappy way to end or start, depending on which way you're going. But people will come here and sit, who knows, just watch the water, relax a little bit. There's that staircase we went up, that's the way out. Now I will say, the way we went, the markings are a lot easier to follow than going the opposite way. But it might be a little bit easier once you get that couple tenths climb to actually run it more, if you're gonna run it, but I don't know. It just needs a lot of work, this little natural area. I know it's a natural area. As you see there, we're coming to the parking lot. Again, I know it's a natural area, but it could be taken care of a lot more than it is. I mean, it would get a lot more traffic and use, just to showcase what it does have to offer, because what it is taken care of, it's a pretty nice 5-mile loop. The hike, I still really wouldn't run it too much. Like today you saw, I was kind of sketchy with it because I just didn't want to twist anything, or because I didn't let anybody know where I was at. But again, it's a nice little area. If it was taken care of, marked a little better, well, we'll say way better than what it is. Even the mile markers, if they were a little bit more visible, it would help a lot. Just stuff like that. And actually cut a couple times a year, be real nice. Let me see, I'll show you the map again. See if I can't show you. So we parked there, and instead of cutting across, remember how I said there's the short loop? There's the short loop. This is the one we took. We went out the whole way around. Then when we cut back in, we did that little section. Trying to think. However you get to there, there's the roads and stuff that, however I said to take you to Lake Evansburg way, but I guess that's it. So, I mean, if you get a chance and you want to do something that's a little bit off-road and not too many people seen, come to the Charles F. Lewis natural area. But, again, wear pants, calf sleeves, or something to protect your legs. And check yourself for ticks, watch for bees, watch for snakes and critters. I guess that's about it.